Hey guys, it's Kenzie, and today I have a very fun video for you guys. I have Apple Music. I'm not sure what everyone else has, but I have Apple Music, and I have quite a bunch of songs downloaded on my phone, and there's a lot of different genres. I'm not sure if anybody else is like me, but I listen to a lot of different genres. I have my writing music, my hard rock, my metal, my country, everything. Like, I literally listen to anything from country to metal, basically. And so my library is quite a mix, and that's kind of why I thought this would be really interesting and fun. I am going to go to all songs and click shuffle, and the first song that comes up, I have to match a book to that song. So what book does that song remind me of? All songs that, and these are songs that I downloaded, so they're songs that I don't necessarily listen to all the time, but I do listen to enough for me to download or have bought in the past. When you run me down and you run my mind, why'd you treat me like that? When you talk to me, it's always on your time, and I don't really need that. I thought that you were speaking to me. Ooh. Make something out of nothing, everyone above me. Ooh. Actually reading this right now, but it is Before the Devil Breaks You by Lipa Bray, and I'm really not putting it as so much the book, but one of the romances in it. I really don't ship Evie and Jericho, or however you say his name. I don't ship him. I don't like Jericho a whole lot. I think he's really annoying to me. And I really ship Evie and Sam. Whenever I like read Evie and Jericho scene, or if I get a Jericho point of view scene, I really hate it, and I really just want to get through it. And this song is kind of about, in my opinion, she is putting her everything on the line for this guy, and he's really just not in it as much as she is, and he's kind of just playing her. I feel that with Jericho a whole lot, in a lot of ways. I feel like he's just really not there for Evie in the way that he should be, and he's just wants her because she's someone who is interesting to him. You are a handful of roses, thorns in a cheap bouquet. True, I'm a walking disaster, they told you to stay away. Seems like I'm making a deal with the devil who's whispering softly to me. Are you sure that she's the one? Cause I feel like a bad joke, walking tightrope.
Again, this is kind of for a relationship, but this whole book is a relationship, about a relationship basically, and that is Brightly Burning by Alexa Dunn. This kind of fits Stella and Hugo's relationship to a T almost. It's more so about like a relationship that is kind of, you know, really confusing, and he doesn't know if it's really like a relationship if he's just making it up in his head. And I feel like that's how Stella feels a lot of the time in this book when she's with Hugo. She's not sure if she's making up the relationship in her head, or if she's actually falling for the guy, or if he actually cares for her the way that she cares for him. I just feel like it matches it perfectly. I'm so bored, I think I'll burn all my clothes. Standing in the bathroom singing along, I don't even like this song. Rolling up, getting comfortable. I've been drinking kitchen table coffee alone. Can never get high enough. Paint dries like my tired eyes. And no one is gonna get me on this, but hear me out. The mood of this song just reminds me of Nova from Renegades, okay? It just reminds me of her. This is Renegades by Melissa Meyer, by the way. I don't know why, but the mood of that song just reminds me of Nova. I feel like her personality kind of matches that. I don't know why I do it. I can't explain it, but when I heard that song, I couldn't stop thinking of Nova. Sing.
Darkest Minds by
Alexander Bracken. I just feel like the mood of this song is the mood I had while reading this book. I don't know, it's just the mood I had, and I just had it and I wanted to share, and that's the book I pick. Also, it's a great book, you should definitely read it. Girls of Paper and Fire by Natasha Nagin. I can't say her last name, I apologize. If you've been on this channel for a while, you know I can't say names. Anyway, I loved this book, it was great. I literally read it in one sitting. Lee and Ren were seriously just like the best couple ever. I ship them so much. I loved them to death. And this song just reminds me of the feeling I had when they were starting to get together. I loved their romance in it, and like the song just really reminded me of when they first started interacting and when they were starting to kind of fall for each other, and they like were really nervous about what the other one thought, and it just reminded me a lot about that. Is this The Hate U Give by Angie Thomas. In my mind, the song is about feeling like you can finally say what you want to say in life, and this whole book is about Star figuring out how she can, whether or not she wants to say the things that she wants to say, if that makes sense. And I feel like that just kind of fits Star in a lot of ways when she finally does get to the point where she understands where she, what she needs to say, how she needs to say it. Thank you so much for watching. Make sure to like the video down below if you enjoyed it, and also subscribe for more, because I am hopefully going to be making more videos. And there's my mother. But I will be making more videos soon, so I will see you guys later on. Goodbye!